Hi, it's Samantha from Samantha by Design. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. Today's time-lapse painting is a very special memorial piece. Unfortunately, the two gentlemen have passed away before the client could get a picture of them and their boys together. We combined seven different pictures to create the perfect painting for them. I absolutely love the way it turned out, and I know this piece will be cherished for years to come. Enjoy the video! I primed my canvas with a coat of burnt sienna, and I've pre-sketched my design and transferred it on with chalk. I'll be painting my background around my subjects to make the process easier and to really let the burnt sienna shine through the skin tones in the finished piece. They really enjoyed the outdoors and being out on the lake, and I wanted to honor that in this background. I started by painting the sky and the clouds, followed by the tree line and then the water, since it's recommended to paint back to front with acrylics. Here I'm mixing my palette for the first portrait. Everyone's skin tone is different, so I repeated this process for the other three people as well when it was time to paint them. I used quite a few colors to get a wide range of skin tones to match all the slight variations I find in the skin. I like to pre-mix my palette ahead of time since acrylic paint tends to dry fast and blending time is crucial for portraits. I always start by painting the eyes first, since the pupil is usually the darkest color in the portrait, and then I can base my values and colors around that. I like to work the hardest parts of the painting first, like the eyes, the nose, and the mouth, since these really define a person. Once those are done, I work on the rest of the face, usually working from dark to light. A good tip to getting a realistic looking portrait is to have a great reference photo. Notice that the whites of the eyes are not pure white and neither are the teeth. There are shades of grays and yellows with some reds and blues. It's important to save your whitest whites for things like reflections of the eye to really make your portrait pop. I would also like to note that when you work with acrylic paints, it's important to remember that the first layer usually looks odd, and it's typically called the ugly stage of the painting. Acrylic paintings look way better if you work with multiple layers. It's also a forgiving medium, and it dries fast, so you can correct mistakes easily and keep working on your painting until you're happy with the results. When I paint hair, I like to focus on clumps and clusters instead of painting every single individual hair. This really helps make the piece look more realistic. Once I was done with the first portrait, I moved on to the second. I mixed a new color palette for him in order to match his skin tones perfectly. Again, I'm working the eyes, nose, and mouth first, working from the darkest colors to the lightest ones. Acrylic paint is a bit harder to blend than oils, so I like to have my working brush with paint on it and a clean damp brush to help my blending. I use transition shades between the dark and light colors and go over them very gently with the damp brush to blur them together without creating a muddy mess. This young man had a lot of freckles and that was really fun to paint. When I paint clothing, I use the same exact methods. I work from dark to light and I work in layers until I'm happy with the painting. Here I'm starting the third portrait, and again I'm mixing a brand new palette to capture all the different skin tones he has. I'm working the same exact process as the other two. Painting takes a lot of practice, but it's so rewarding. It took me a while to find a portrait technique that I like, and it's important for you to find things that work for you. Don't be afraid to keep working on your painting until you're happy with the results. The piece isn't done until you are. The key to getting a soft hairline that doesn't look fake is to make sure you use a transition shade between your hair color and your skin tone. And we're on to number four. Again, I'm remixing a new color palette to match him. He really liked being outdoors, so his skin had a lot more red and brown tones than the other three did. I really enjoy commissions like this. Life passes by so fast, and sometimes our favorite people don't get to meet. But I get to create beautiful pieces where they can all exist together, and that makes my heart really happy. When painting facial hair, it's important to remember to work in layers and in different colors. Hairs that are pointing straight out towards you are actually just tiny little dots. And here's what the finished painting looks like. If you've enjoyed this video, please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell to be notified when I upload next. It really helps me out. You can find the link to my social media accounts in the description below. Thank you so much for tuning in. I appreciate you a lot, and have a wonderful day. Bye!